Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Beer Geek Nation. I'm yours, Chris. Thank you so much for joining me once again for another beer review. And today, guys, we are looking at a beer that a ton of you guys have requested for me to review. This one is the one, the only, the Dogfish Head 75-minute IPA, 7.5% alcohol by volume, just got released. What this is basically a blend of 60-minute of their 60-minute IPA and a blend of their 90-minute IPA. Get those together, brew those together, dry hop it with a ton of Cascade hops, and then they bottle condition this one with maple syrup. So a really, really interesting take on an IPA. This has previously been released a bunch of times at the Dogfish Head pub itself, so you were able to get it there if you ever went there. So looking forward to this one. I've heard nothing but really good things about it, and a lot of you guys, I think, want to know. So let me get into a glass so you guys know what it smells, tastes, and give you the verdict on the Dogfish Head 75-minute IPA. All right, guys, so the appearance on the 75-minute IPA, it is a beautiful, beautiful yellow, golden orange. It's lighter in the yellow spectrum, where it actually hits the curves of the glass there. There is an epic amount of carbonation coming off the bottom of this glass. I mean, it looks like champagne. You guys can see in the video, there was a 4 to 5 finger, really white, billowy, fluffy, creamy looking head on there. It is a bottle conditioned beer, so you're gonna get a big head like that. It is sticking around like crazy, tons of lacing. It is a beautiful beer. All right, guys, the aroma on the 75-minute IPA. Wow, yeah, definitely getting the big 60-minute IPA characters. Big grapefruit, there's like a West Coast pininess in there, like a toastiness, a nice caramel note, definitely some breadiness in there as well. Definitely gonna get a sweetness from the maple syrup. It really helps to kind of mellow out the almost overwhelming amount of grapefruit characters. Yeah, it's a really, really interesting smelling IPA. All right, guys, the taste on the 75-minute IPA from Dogfish Head. Cheers. Right at the front of the tongue, there's a nice, nice, almost, again, like a West Coast type of bitterness. Again, a 60-minute IPA type of bitterness. Big grapefruit. Middle of the mouth, I'm getting, a caramel, toffee, kind of woodsy note in there. A spicy kind of herbal quality. And that's more of a 90-minute thing, but definitely getting some more of that grapefruit. It's like a grapefruit skin or an orange peel. A little bit of tropical fruit. Definitely getting some of that maple syrup in there as well, and that's really helping to kind of cut some of the bitterness and blend in some of the malts with the bitterness itself. Nice dry finish on this one. Really nice dry finish. It finishes like a white wine or a champagne. Aftertaste, definitely getting more grapefruit. Lots of grapefruit one. This is a really grapefruit forward beer. A lot of woodsiness again. A little bit of almost like a oaky kind of character in there. Nice herbal, malty, caramel, toffee character in the aftertaste as well. It's a really, really well balanced but kind of hop forward beer. Really nice stuff. All right, guys, so the final verdict on the Dogfish Head 75-minute IPA, 7.5% alcohol by volume, available now in 750s only, which is a little bit disappointing, to be honest with you. For me, this is easily the best IPA that Dogfish has done. It's better than their Squall. It's better than April Hop. Honestly, I think it's better than their 60 and their 90, which are two of my kind of staples. Just big, massive grapefruit citrus qualities with that big malty backbone like you get in the 90-minute. Nice dry finish, and then they add that kind of that maple syrup in there to bottle condition it so you get that big velvet feel. Just a big twist kind of on the IPA. It kind of creates another kind of level of texture to the beer, a nice kind of sweetness to it to help kind of balance out the big grapefruit in this one. And I do want to say something. It actually says that this has ageability on it. I wouldn't do that if I were you. Tasting this beer now, I was thinking about putting one in the cellar, but this is a big, big hoppy grapefruit forward beer, and I think you hop heads are really gonna dig it. I mean, if you can get extra bottles, stick one in the cellar, see what happens, who knows, because of that maple syrup and the natural bottle conditioning, it might work. So with that said, guys, this one's gonna get an A+ from me. Really, really awesome stuff. I definitely recommend it. It's really, really reasonably priced too. So really awesome stuff. They put it in a bottle, glad to see it. And remember, folks, life is too short. Drink amazing beers. Cheers.